P.E.
Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to P.E. with Miss McGill. Now, this doesn't exactly look like me, but it'll do for now. Now, I've decided to call you guys exercisers, because, let's face it, when you're with me, you are exercisers. You're exercising your body and your mind. Welcome to week 13. Now you can have anyone join you. A friend, a family member, a pet, even grandpa.
Last week, we recorded our BPM, or beats per minute, before, during, and after our exercises. Our old pal BPM Girl showed up to help us record our BPM. We learned about the word vigorous and how it means fast, powerful, and energetic. We learned that the more vigorous our activity is, the more oxygen our body needs. And the more oxygen our body needs, the more times our heart beats. And the more times our heart beats, the more blood that is pumped to our muscles.
More vigorous, more oxygen. More oxygen, more beats. More beats, more blood. More power to your muscles. Two of the main types of exercises are aerobic. What? No, no, that's... Okay, that's the wrong spot. Aerobic. Aerobic. Oh my goodness. What in the world? Aerobic. Aerobic exercise is with air. It means your breathing and your heart rate increase for a long period of time. Say the word aerobic with me 3 times in a row. Ready? Go! Aerobic, aerobic, aerobic. Then there's anaerobic. Well, anaerobic exercise needs quick bursts of energy with maximum effort for a short time. So we don't really need a lot of air to do anaerobic exercises. Say anaerobic 3 times with me. Go. Anaerobic, anaerobic, anaerobic. Aerobic. Here are some examples of aerobic exercises. Walking. Biking. Jogging. Running. And swimming. Anaerobic. Here are some examples of anaerobic exercises. Sprinting. Jumping. And lifting heavy objects like boxes or weights.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, pizza and toast. Pizza and toast? What am I? Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Exercise Game Show, where I will show you a short clip of me exercising, and then you will decide whether that's an anaerobic exercise or an aerobic exercise. Let's play.
Swimming. Swimming is an exercise that requires a lot of air, where your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time. Is swimming aerobic or anaerobic? Swimming is aerobic. It needs a lot of air because your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time. Sprinting. Sprinting means running as fast as you can for a short time. It doesn't require much air, and it requires quick bursts of maximum energy. Is sprinting aerobic or anaerobic? Sprinting is anaerobic. It doesn't require much air because it is done for a short period of time with quick bursts of maximum energy. Biking. Biking is an exercise that requires a lot of air because your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time. Is biking aerobic or anaerobic? Biking is aerobic. It requires a lot of air because your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time. Jumping. Jumping is an exercise that doesn't require much air because this is done for a short period of time with quick bursts of maximum energy. Is jumping aerobic or anaerobic? Jumping is anaerobic. It doesn't require much air because it is done for a short period of time with quick bursts of maximum energy. Walking. Walking is an exercise that requires a lot of air because your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time. Is walking aerobic or anaerobic? Walking is aerobic. It requires a lot of air because your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time. Lifting things like large boxes and lifting weights is an exercise that doesn't require much air because this is done for a short period of time with quick bursts of maximum energy. Is lifting aerobic or anaerobic? Lifting is anaerobic. It doesn't require much air because it is done for a short period of time with quick bursts of maximum energy. Jogging. Jogging is an exercise that requires a lot of air because your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time. Is jogging aerobic or anaerobic? Jogging is aerobic. It requires a lot of air because your breathing and heart rate increase for a long period of time.
Question.
Which exercise requires more air, aerobic or anaerobic? The correct answer is aerobic.
Yay!
Great job exercising your brain. Since we are going to be exercising our bodies with kicking today, the most appropriate stretches to begin with are leg stretches. Stretches. Feel free to sing along with some original Miss Miguel songs during the stretches.
Biceps, triceps, hamstrings, quads, abs, and obliques aren't too far. Latissimus dorsi, also called lats, deltoids, pectorals, and my calves. These are the muscles in my body parts, my trunk, my legs, and my arms. Biceps, triceps, hamstrings, quads, abs, and obliques aren't too far. Latissimus dorsi, also called lats, deltoids, pectorals, and my calves. These are the muscles in my body parts, my trunk, my legs, and my arms.
Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift. Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift. Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift. Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift.
Stay standing. I'm kneeling so that you can see my arms during the entire stretch.
Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift. Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift. Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift. Lift with your legs, lift with your legs, lift.
Oxygen heart lungs. Blood and muscles, oxygen heart lungs. Blood and muscles. Oxygen heart lungs. Blood and muscles, oxygen heart lungs. Blood and muscles,
10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6, 10 beats times 6. 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6. 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6, 10 beats times 6. 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 6, 10 beat 10 beat 10 beat 6.
More vigorous, more oxygen. More oxygen, more beats. More beats, more blood. More power to your muscles. All right, exercisers, it's time to mirror me and warm up those muscles.
Thank you.
PPCT. This stands for planks, push-ups, curl-ups, and trunk lift. Emma's going to squat down and crawl forward and show you half plank position. You may also use full plank position if you choose. What is your plank goal? Would you like to plank for 25 seconds, 30 seconds, or would you like to try to go for the whole 60 seconds? Make sure each day your goal is at least the same as yesterday or 1 second more. Exercisers, ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60. Great job! Okay, exercisers, it's goal time again. What is your push-up goal for today? Are you going to try to do 2? 4? Are you going to try to go all the way to 10? Whatever your goal is, make sure it's either the same as yesterday or at least one more.
We'll now begin the push-up section. Ready? Begin. Down. Up. 1. Down. Up, 2, down, up, 3, down, up, 4, down, up, 5, down, up, 6, down, up, 7, down, up, 8, down, up, 9, down, up, 10.
What is your curl-up goal, exercisers? Is it 1? Is it 6? Or maybe you're trying to go all the way to 12 today. Make sure your goal today is either the same as yesterday or one more than yesterday at the very least. If you do need someone to hold your feet down, that's okay if your curl-ups are looking like this. Remember, feet flat, hands flat, knees to the sky. Make sure your hands are sliding forward across the ground with each curl up. If you need someone to hold your feet, here are a few different ways they can do that. And if there's no one available to help you, remember you can always put something heavy on your feet or put your feet underneath a chair or couch.
We'll begin the curl ups now. Ready? Begin. Up. Down. 1. Up. Down, 2, up, down, 3, up, down, 4, up, down, 5, up, down, 6, up, down, 7, up, down, 8, up, down, 9, up, down, 10, up, down, 11, up, down, 12.
And now we're moving on to trunk lifts. You're going to lay down on your stomach. You're going to make sure your palms are facing up. And you're going to lift up, bringing your chin up as far as you can. Let's do 5 trunk lifts together. Up. 1. Up. 2. Up, 3. Up, 4. Up, 5.
Water, 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 break.
Welcome back, and happy Thursday, exercisers. We're going to do some more punting today. This is just a reminder that if you are doing this video inside of your house, please use an imaginary ball so that you don't destroy anything inside of your house. Thank you. Let's review the correct way to punt a ball. Begin with your feet shoulder-width apart. Now tap on the leg that you kick with. Extend your arms out as far as you can and lock your elbows. Now step, drop, kick. Today I want you to focus your eyes on a target. So while you're doing your step, drop, kick, I want you to focus your eyes on where you would want the imaginary ball to go. Join me now in doing step, drop, kick. 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 Step, drop, step, drop, kick. Step, drop, kick. Step, drop.
Whoa! You need to ask permission first before you kick a pillow or a stuffed animal or a sock ball.
Hey, but if you're inside, you should be kicking an imaginary ball. Now, when you're done with this video, I want you to find a ball, go outside somewhere safe, and practice your step, drop, kick, and work on that punt.
Question.
Fill in the blank. Step, kick. The correct answer is drop. Yay! Now, we're going to move on to kicking a stationary ball. A stationary ball is a ball that's not moving. Touch the inside of your foot with your hands. That's the area on our foot that we'll be kicking with today.
What? No, 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 not your toes. That's right. No way. Can't kick with the toes. We could injure our toes very badly if we... Oh, no. Lost it. Lost my foot. Kicked with my toes. Destroyed it.
No foot. Footless.
Yep. Here I go.
Okay, that was a little dramatic. My foot is not gone. If you're doing this video inside, use something to mark where your pretend ball would be. You're going to step with your planting foot and plant your foot right next to the ball. Then swing your kicking foot using the inside of your foot to kick the ball. Practice those kicks now. Great job, exercisers. Now remember, if you can, practice those kicks outdoors.
Question.
When you kick a stationary ball, what part of your foot do you use? The correct answer is the inside of your foot, not your toes. We have to warm up our bodies and we have to cool them down to prevent injury. During cool down number one, we want to make sure that our shoulders are back and that they're above our hips and that our ears are above our shoulders so we're not leaning forward. Place one hand on your chest and one on your abdomen. Take deep breaths in through your nose and out through your mouth. You can close your eyes if you'd like. Focus on nothing else but your breathing right now, in through your nose out through your mouth. Now keep breathing at your own pace. Breathe in, chest in. Breathe out, abdomen out. Breathe in, chest in. Breathe out, abdomen out. Have both of your hands switch places. And one last deep breath in through the nose and out through the mouth. Now arm raises in and out. You may go at your own pace. Next, spread your feet apart and put your hands over the center of your chest. Take a deep breath in and twist to the side. Deep breath out and come back to the center of your chest. Switch hands, deep breath in, out. Switch hands, deep breath in and out, back to the center. And switch hands. Continue at your own pace. While you're breathing, remember to take care of yourself. Remember that you are important. Remember to always look in your mirror and not out your window. Stance, you can point your toes out. Next, you can put your palms together or you can put your hands together any way that feels comfortable. You're going to bring your elbows back and forward, opening up your chest and closing it back up again. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. You can bring your head into it if you'd like. Breathe in, head up. Breathe out all the way down. Continue at your own pace.
Question.
At school, what does PE stand for? The correct answer is physical education.
One last time, in through your nose, arms backwards, out through your mouth, arms forwards. Excellent job today. And a special thank you to our inspiration, our friends at the Nairoga Institute who visited our teachers.